Penguin Random House Audio presents Old Time Radio's Greatest Shows, Volume 46, featuring Clark Gable, Jack Webb, Charles Laughton, and many more. Edited by Carl Amari.
Abbott and Costello program. Tonight's guest, one of radio's favorite comedians, Judy Canova, and starring Bud Abbott and Lou Costello.
Hey, Abbott!
Oh, there you are, Costello.
Here it is, the first program of the new year, and you're late.
Oh, so I'm late?
Yeah.
Well, it's all on account of leap year, Abbott. I was passing the corner on Hollywood and Vine, and 30 women jumped on me.
30 women at Hollywood?
30.
At Hollywood and Vine?
Hollywood and Vine.
That's where the wolves hang out.
This year, it's Wolverines.
Oh, stop.
Okay. Boy, you should see these women fighting over me, Abbott. One of them grabbed my left arm, another grabbed my right arm, then one grabbed my other leg, then one grabbed the other leg, one grabbed my ears, my nose, my hair.
Ah, wait a minute. But why should that make you late?
Well, I had to go to Lockheed to get reassembled.
Well, it's leap year, and you've got to expect those things.
Yeah, but I wasn't even safe, Abbott, at Lockheed. As soon as I walked in, a dame threw her arms around me and kissed me 12 times before I could even kiss her once.
She kissed you 12 times to your once?
Yeah, she was a riveter.
Hey, a riveter kissed you? I don't believe it.
Oh, you don't.
Now, Costello, don't run down leap year. Will you please, Lou?
Listen. Maybe I didn't read it right.
Lou, will you listen to Buddy? Don't run down leap year.
This is an
excellent. This is an excellent opportunity for some nice girl to propose to you. And then you can settle down and get married.
Wait a minute, Abbott. Who wants to get married? I don't want no mother-in-law.
What's wrong with a mother-in-law? Do you know what a mother-in-law is?
Sure. A mother-in-law is the Gestapo with bloomers.
But, Costello, marriage is wonderful. Wouldn't you like to have people throw rice at you?
No, when my brother got married, they threw rice at him. It's too messy.
Rice isn't messy.
It is when it's mixed with chop suey.
You ain't gonna get it.
All right, talk sense, please. Look, Lou, weddings are beautiful, Costello. Don't you like the old-fashioned unions?
No, they itch me all over.
Oh. Will you cut that out? Your underwear doesn't fit our conversation.
My underwear will fit anything, brother.
All right. Never mind that, Costello. I still say that a wife is your best friend.
Oh, no. Your mother is your best friend. And I think it's a shame when they have just one holiday for your mother and two for your father.
Two holidays for your father? What are they?
Father's Day and Puppy's Day.
Costello, you're talking like that because you haven't even got a girl.
Oh, yes, I have, Abbott. I got a girl. I got a big book full of girls' names, all in alphabetical order.
And what's the first name in the book?
Zelda.
Zelda.
Hello, fellows.
Hey, it's Ken Niles. Hello, Ken.
Well, I'm sorry I'm late. I just came from the blood bank.
You just came from the blood bank? Look, Niles, they want plasma, not asthma.
Now, you stop that, Costello.
That Niles is so anemic that a mosquito bit him and lost blood on the deal.
Oh, shut up. Ken, I'm glad you dropped in. Costello and I have had quite a discussion here. He's been running down marriage.
Running down marriage? Mm. Why, Costello, marriage is wonderful. Look at Abbott and me.
Yes, Costello. Ken and I are married.
Oh, congratulations. I hope you two guys will be very happy.
No.
How do you like that, Freddy? Those two guys are married.
No.
I didn't think it was legal.
Now, wait a minute. I don't mean it that way. Don't.
Hey, two men
just
married.
Just a minute, please. Now, don't be stupid.
I know somebody that married a man.
Look, just who?
My sister.
Yeah, your sister. All right, never mind. Look, come here, Lou. Let's take Ken Niles and his wife.
Came from left field, didn't
he? Look, just a minute, will you? Let's take Ken Niles and his wife.
Oh, sure, we'll take him. We'll take him.
Now, there's a happy married couple.
That's right, Bud. Why, I can't stand to be away from my wife for a second. When I leave the house in the morning, she goes with me. I take her to the office, to the golf club. Even when I go out with the boys, she goes with me.
Now, did you hear that, Costello? Niles takes his wife every place he goes.
Sure. Did you ever get a load of the puss on that dame? He'd rather take her with him than kiss her goodbye.
Oh, I insulted you!
remark. Oh, I heard that remark, short and dumpy. You should talk about anybody's appearance. You with your double chin.
I got no double chin. It's my necktie.
Then your necktie needs a shave.
Oh, darling, you're so funny. You kill me.
Oh, no, no, dear. You're funny than I am. You kill me.
No, honey, you kill me.
Oh, no, you kill me.
If there's anybody out there with a hunting license, what are you waiting for?
I want you to stop that, Costello. Come here. You understand that? I want you to stop it. Mr. and Mrs. Niles are a wonderful example of marriage.
Yes,
look at Ken standing there holding her hand.
If he ever lets go, she'll beat his brains out.
That's not true, Costello. Our marriage has been perfect. Well, I'll never forget our wedding day. Oh, I look so lovely in my bridal veil.
You'd even look better in a bridal.
Don't listen to him, Mrs. Niles. Please, pay no attention to him. Go ahead, tell us more about your wedding day.
Oh, it was thrilling. You know, Kenneth and I had a runaway marriage.
Yeah, he ran away and you ran after him.
I did not. I don't chase men. They chase me. Why, New Year's Day, I had dozens of men chasing after me.
I know. You played with Washington in a Rose Bowl game.
Why, I know nothing about Washington.
Not even George?
Oh, well, yes, I was with him at Valley Forge. Oh, you stop that! Oh, come, Kenneth!
Now, look what you did, Costello.
Well, look what I did. You started the whole thing, Abbott, trying to talk me into getting married. You're not going to get me tied with any dame.
Hello, Costello speaking.
Mr. Costello, let me be the first to congratulate you on your decision about women. Women are nothing but trouble. I know. I've been married. I say down with women.
Gee, thanks for backing me up, friend. I wish I could do some favor for you.
You can. Make them let me out of here. I'm all right, I tell you. I'm all right.
You see, Costello, that proves what I said. Marriage is a wonderful institution.
Oh, yeah? Look at the institution he's in.
Get out of here.
Now I'm telling you, Abbott, for the last time. The last time I don't want to get married.
But, Costello, you're being silly. Marriage is great. And there's nothing like having a place to come home to. Why, even the president. When he came home from Cairo, arrived at the gates of the White House and whistled. And who came out?
Fowler. He's always home.
Look, let's talk sense.
Now, anyway, Abbott, I'm sick and tired of talking sense. All year I get talk sense. If I get married, I'd have to give up my career. You know, I'm a beachcomber at the Union Station.
A beachcomber in a railroad station?
Sure, I stand there and watch the waves come in.
Oh. Watch the waves come in. That's about the only way you could get a girl.
Is that so? You may not know it, Abbott, but Cary Grant and I go 50-50 on girls.
Really?
Of course. He gets them under 50 and I get all those over.
Come in. Oh, it's Connie Haynes. Hello, Connie.
Hello, Mr. Abbott. Hello, my fat little sugar man. Mr. Costello.
Yeah?
This being leap year, I want to propose to you. I want to marry you before some beautiful actress gets you.
Gee, Connie, do you think that I'm handsome?
No, but they're running out of the handsome ones, and they'll be taken there from your class next.
Connie, are you really in love with Costello?
Yes, I am. Mr. Costello.
Yes?
Last night I dreamed that you took me to dinner.
Dream on, girl.
Then I dreamed that you took me to the Trocadero for dancing.
Dream on, kid.
And then I dreamed that you bought me the most beautiful mink coat.
Wake up! Wake up!
Costello, what's wrong with you? Here a lovely girl throws herself at you and you don't appreciate it.
Yes, I don't drink, I don't stay out late, I don't pet. I'm a nice girl.
Well, I don't drink, I don't stay out late, and I don't pet.
Gee, you're a nice girl, too.
Sure.
Now you see what you did, Costello? You just don't know how to...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.